रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवतम कैंटो 4 चैप्टर 6 टेक्स्ट नंबर 31 वैदुर्यकृत सोपाना वाप्या उत्पलमालिनी प्राप्तं किं पुरुषे दृष्ट्वा ता आराददृशुर्वितम्। ट्रांसलेशन बाय श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय। दे ऑल्सो सॉ दैट द बेदिंग गार्ड्स एंड देयर स्टेयरकेसेस वर मेड ऑफ वैदुर्य मणि। द वाटर वॉज फुल ऑफ लोटस फ्लावर्स। पासिंग बाय सच लेक्स द डेमिगॉड्स रीच्ड अ प्लेस where there was a great banyan tree. No purport, so we shall discuss little more about the previous purport. Whenever there is a nice atmosphere in the material world, immediately there is an awakening of the sexual appetite in the minds of materialistic persons. This tendency is present everywhere within this material world, not only on this earth but in higher planetary systems as well. In complete contrast with the influence of this atmosphere on the minds of the living entities within the material world, is a description of the spiritual world. The women here are hundreds and thousands of times more beautiful than the women here in this material world. And the spiritual atmosphere is also many times better. Yet despite the pleasant atmosphere, the minds of the denizens do not become agitated, because in the spiritual world, the Vaikuntha planets, the spiritualistic minds of the inhabitants are so much absorbed in the spiritual vibration of chanting the glories of the Lord that such enjoyment could not be surpassed by any other enjoyment, even sex, which is a culmination of all pleasure in the material world. In other words, in Vaikuntha world, in spite of its better atmosphere and facilities, there is no impetus for sex life. As stated in Bhagavad Gita, Param Drishtva Nivartate, the inhabitants are so spiritually enlightened that in the presence of such spirituality, sex life is insignificant. So, yesterday we talked about the explanation of this Param Drishtva Nivartate, how the Vaishnava's way of not even say controlling, the Vaishnava's way of ignoring, there's nothing to control. The Vaishnava's way of ignoring the Maya pleasures is by simply being absorbed in the higher taste of Krishna consciousness. Krishna consciousness is a taste of the soul. It is a soul happiness. And serving Krishna is a soul pleasure. So when the soul is absorbed in engaging the yantra in service of the Lord, in the background of Krishna consciousness happiness, one is fully satisfied and one will not be diverted by this Maya pleasures. So that is the method of controlling our senses. That is the method of full engagement of our yantra in service of the Lord. In the background of soul happiness will ensure that our yantra gets slowly purified little by little, because this is in the material world. What do? We try to inject pleasure from the yantra to the soul, is it not? From the yantra we try to inject pleasure into the soul. But soul is never satisfied. Krishna consciousness means you inject pleasure from the soul to the yantra, the reverse. With soul happiness, you engage the yantra in different services of the Lord for the pleasure of the Lord. Then actually our yantra also becomes purified. And even yantra also gives pleasure to the devotee as an instrument of the Lord. So only the lower kind of pleasures of sense gratification, that is rejected, because that is meant for animals, that is meant for those who are in the Maya. Those who are in the Maya, for them it is the Ananda Ahara. the different kinds of pleasures of the body, mind, intelligence, social ego. So these things are simply food for the hungry soul, who is hungry from soul happiness and soul pleasure. So therefore, we have to first, if we do not know what is soul happiness, we have to learn and teach ourselves what is soul happiness. And soul happiness is the happiness of Krishna consciousness, and that is the higher taste. It's a consciousness taste. It is not a sense taste. It's a consciousness taste. It's an existential happiness. It is the happiness of belonging to Krishna. It is the happiness of being of the same quality as Krishna. It is the happiness of being eternal. It is the happiness of being eternal part and parcel and being taken care, protected and provided by the Lord. It is the happiness of the Lord in the heart of the Yantra, who is always guiding us with intelligence. The happiness of having him as our dear friend in our heart, infusing his intelligence into our intelligence to take us back to Godhead, to bring a spiritual master, to take us to the lotus feet of a spiritual master who will teach us how to recover my soul happiness and soul pleasure. The purpose of existence is enjoyment. Once some press reporters asked Srila Prabhupada, what is the purpose of humanity? He said, to enjoy. So the devotee was very surprised. And devotee thought Prabhupada will say, you have to surrender to Krishna, you have to, give up meat eating, all that. But he gave one line answer to the person. It is to enjoy. What kind of enjoyment? Anandamayobhyasat. That is the answer of the Vedanta Sutra. That is the answer of the Vedas. It's not his, it's the answer of the Vedas. Every jiva's innermost urge is ananda, to enjoy. The reporter asked Srila Prabhupada, can you produce some miracles of walking on the water or turning water into wine? Prabhupada said, you can bring a naked woman before me, nothing will happen to me, but you will be disturbed. That is a miracle. So that is the power of Krishna consciousness. Like here Prabhupada says, the purport. One is absorbed in the rasa of chanting the glories of the Lord, all others are ignored, ignorable, easily ignorable, insignificant, ignorable. So, these things we need to practice in life. We know these things so much, we hear so much. We need to practice this by faith, by injecting this transcendental pleasure from the soul plane to the body, to the yantra. Where do you feed the soul? Soul you have to feed from Prabhupada. Soul happiness source is what? This. The ocean of happiness. Ocean of soul happiness. Which we should know how to take it. That's the only thing. How to take this. Submissive oral reception. We absorb ourselves in receiving the transcendental words spoken by Srila Prabhupada. When you read Srila Prabhupada, you don't see the printed matter, you don't see the book, you hear Prabhupada. A new person may not, but after becoming a devotee of Srila Prabhupada for so many years, when you take read of Prabhupada's book, Prabhupada speaks to you. So that is why he said you should hear Srila Prabhupada. When you hear Srila Prabhupada, our soul will get injected with soul happiness. Another famous pastime of Srila Prabhupada is about going to in San Francisco, the head of a nude camp invited Prabhupada to come. There is like a forest. All the people are all nude. No dress, men, women, nothing. And they are all some seekers of, you know, what is life truth. They want to seek. Not poor guys. All youngsters. So they are all, the nude camp. So somebody will be sitting on a tree. Somebody will be walking here, there. All kinds of things. Just free. And doping. Drugs. Drugs also they will take. So, the head of that, I think, invited Prabhupada. So Prabhupada went there. They had placed a nice honorable seat for Prabhupada, wooden platform. So Prabhupada went there. All these nudies were around him. They came and sat in front of him, all the nudies, men and women. Prabhupada did a kirtan. Hare Krishna kirtan he did. Prabhupada and devotees did a kirtan. And we did not talk anything. At least this is what one version. Another version I have heard is Prabhupada in his talk, he said, how have we become so degraded? And one person in that group, you are shocked. Prabhupada, this old man is saying we are degraded. That means we had some grade. So after Prabhupada came back after the kirtan, that person put on his clothes and joined the temple. Not only he joined temple, he became one of the top leaders in the movement. Now we don't want to tell the name. Because such a poor ashram of sannyasi and all, you should not tell. So, this is the thing. So Prabhupada, I can go anywhere. Even to a nude camp to preach Krishna consciousness. You ask any other sannyasi, nude camp. How can I go there? Prabhupada was not sannyasi, he was a paramahamsa. Yeah, sannyasi should follow that. But Prabhupada was a paramahamsa. Beyond. Paramahamsa's paramahamsa. Paramahamsa is fourth stage of sannyasa, isn't it? Prabhupada was paramahamsa of paramahamsas. Totally transcendental. Vaikuntha person. From the spiritual world, his heart is filled with Krishna conscious happiness. All these things, nothing. So it all depends on how we fill our mind with Krishna conscious happiness. Then based on that, to counter all these things is very easy. We can ignore them. We get ignored. When there is no light, even a candle is very important. Isn't it? So when you are starved, when your heart is starved of happiness and pleasure, of Krishna consciousness, then even fake light, like mirage in the desert, actually there is no water at all. It's not that there is little water. In a mirage, is appearance of water in the desert. and you think, I'll get it. This mirage, just like camel example, mirage example of Prabhupada also is very good, very interesting. I think it's in Bhagavatam itself. You see, when you chase in a desert, you see there is some water. That's because of the air, different densities in the air. It looks like water is there on the surface of the water. You go nearer and nearer, it goes farther and farther. So yeah, there is water. But actually there is not one drop of water. So that is why Prabhupada says there is no happiness at all in the material, in the spiritual world, in the material world. Because happiness means soul's eternal happiness. It has to be eternal happiness. It has to come out of eternal relationship with Krishna. It has to come out of our eternal position. So there is no happiness at all in this material world. This is one thing that the devotees, any Vaishnava should be first convinced of. It's a different matter that the yantra will have its own old tendencies and all that thing. But at least one should differentiate that it is not mine. That is stage one. These are not my desires. These are my old desires. My old enjoyer egos, which are all contaminated and sitting in my contaminated consciousness. Earlier I used to enjoy and the same sense object comes, all that memory is jumping up and say, now enjoy. It's not me. So that is as far as the old things are concerned, but at least we should be convinced. Two separate things it should be. You should be convinced that this is Maya pleasure, conditioned pleasure. I have to change my conditioning. To change my conditioning, I have to restrain. To restrain, I will not be successful unless I feed my soul with Krishna consciousness. Higher taste. Unless I have higher taste, I cannot restrain. I cannot successfully restrain. So reading Srila Prabhupada books is very important to keep ourselves filled with transcendental consciousness, happiness of Krishna consciousness. Next verse we'll read. Sayo jana shatotsedaha padona vitapayataha paryakritachala chayo nirnidas tapavarjitaha. That banyan tree was 800 miles high and its branches spread over 600 miles around. The tree cast a fine shadow which permanently cooled the temperature, yet there was no noise of birds. Purport. Generally in every tree there are bird nests and the birds congregate in the evening and create noise. But it appears that this banyan tree was devoid of nests and therefore it was calm, quiet and peaceful. There is no disturbance from the noise or heat and therefore this place was just suitable for meditation. Tasmin mahayogamaye mumukshu sharane suraha dadrishuhu shivam asinam tektamarsham ivantakam. The demigod saw Lord Shiva sitting under the tree, which was competent to give perfection to mystic yogis and deliver all people. As grave as time eternal, he appeared to have given up all anger. Purport. In this verse, the word Mahayogamaya is very significant. Yoga means meditation on the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and Mahayoga means those who engage in devotion service of Vishnu. Meditation means remembering, smaranam. There are 9 different kinds of devotion service of which smaranam is one purpose. The yogis remember the form of Vishnu within his heart. Thus there are many devotees engaged in meditation on Lord Vishnu under the big banyan tree. The Sanskrit word maha is derived from the affix mahat. This affix is used when there is a great number of quantity. So Mahaya Yoga indicates that there are many great yogis and devotees meditating on the form of Lord Vishnu. Generally, such meditators are desirous of liberation from material bondage and they are promoted to the spiritual world, to one of Vaikuntha lokas, Vaikunthas. Liberation means freedom from material bondage or nascience. In the material world, we are suffering life after life because of our bodily identification, and liberation is freedom from that miserable condition of life. So, Lord Shiva was sitting under the tree and it is said that he was grave as eternal time. and he appeared to have given up all anger. The many times that Srila Prabhupada also was very angry to teach his disciples for the purpose of teaching, for the purpose of playing his role, as a spiritual master in service of the jivas for the pleasure of the Lord, Prabhupada exhibited anger several times. Everything has a place, and in Lord's creation, and nothing is spared by a pure devotee. Not that he is, Prabhupada always said that just to correct them, he has to become angry sometimes. So there is one pastime I'll read. Chit Sukhananda, he is narrating. The next morning we got up 5:45, just before sunrise, and Prabhupada came into the little temple room in that rustic house. When Srila Prabhupada realized that we had arisen late, he was very serious, almost angry. He began class without revealing his mind, but we could tell that something was wrong. Shyam Sundar made some mistakes reading the Sanskrit, and Prabhupada said, "You are traveling with me for so many months and you do not know these verses?" Towards the end of the lecture, Prabhupada said, "Why are you all getting up late? I know you are traveling and you must be tired, but you must be up in the morning no matter what. You can rest later, but you must be up in the morning." Then he said, "Chit Sukhananda, is this getting up at 6 in the morning going on in your temple?" I said, "No, Srila Prabhupada." He said, "You must be very careful. You may travel, but you must rise and chant no matter what." We all felt bad, especially since I was primary host in these places. I thought, we have had 5 days of ecstasy, but now we are getting the nectar of a little chastisement. Then I thought, "Oh my God, now that he is unhappy and has seen how fallen we are, maybe I have ruined his trip." After the class, he went outside to go to his quarters and I ran behind him. As I went, I picked up some jasmine flowers to offer to him. I said, "Srila Prabhupada, please take these flowers." He turned to me and said, "Thank you," and smiled brightly. I said, "Srila Prabhupada, your appearance like an angry lion has gone." He said, "I am never angry with any of you." This was after we had felt his thunderbolts for an hour. He said, "When you fall from the path, my duty is to put you back on, that's all. Otherwise, there is no anger." I said, "Thank you, Srila Prabhupada." His anger is displayed only for the care of the child, just as a parent may. Don't do that. So Prabhupada was the same way with us. We were his young children. Srila Prabhupada ki. So, like this, we should never misunderstand so many pastimes of Srila Prabhupada, where he's, you know, he becomes so angry. You know, devotees describe that his lips were twitching. So it is all his rasa, because he is doing pure devotional service. So anybody who gets chastised like that is a recipient of great mercy of a pure devotee. Any questions?
Hare Krishna, Dhanvasbhu. In your previous class, you were telling that sex desire is 90% in the mind. Would you throw some more light into this, Prabhu?
99% in the mind means 99% concoction. Sex desire is 90% This has a property. This property of shine is coming from this kartal. The qualities of brass is coming from this kartal. Take a gulab jamun and put it on your tongue. the quality of that pleasure, then by Lord's arrangement, there is an objective quality of pleasure. What is the pleasure in the sense object? Objective pleasure in the sense object. Okay? So that you put, it will taste, your tongue will taste that, you, whether your mind is involved or not. Okay? Mind can amplify it. Suppose somebody keeps a, you know, gulab jamun, and then in your room, and every day he says, don't open, don't open, don't open. No, no, you cannot open today, you cannot open today. And then after 1 month he opens, your gulab jamun will taste more. 100%. Because it amplifies. Mind is added something to the objective pleasure. Mind is added something to the objective pleasure. What is that added? How does the mind add? Hope, 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 hope. I got it. Hope, hope, hope. I got it. That is success pleasure. So when you tease somebody, when you tease, finally when you give, I got it. So there is a mind which is amplifying the pleasure each time you contemplate. So by contemplation, this magnification happens. So 95% of the sex pleasure is like this. Only 1% something, anything, any object has got. Sensation of touch will be there. So this is 99% objective pleasure. Objective pleasure from the body, from the female ego, male ego, because that's also material, no? Material ego. So material ego has a material object. Male ego has got a material object called female ego. So you see, it's a female ego. So female ego and male ego, for a moment, something, some exchanges. It is all, objectively speaking also, it's nothing. But it is amplified by the mind, by hope, desire, hope, then success. Then this cycle is there in our, is, it becomes a habit. In our brain, just like you take alcohol every day, then you need alcohol, brain will ask. Similarly, you create this concocted habit of sex desire, brain will ask. Why brain is asking? Every day it has to get that, the brain cells are asking, where is that chemical? Where is that chemical? And that chemical is all wired in such a way that it comes out of mental concoction. Sum and substance is just like, if you see, if you're not excited about sex, you cannot enjoy sex. There'll be only objective pleasure. Why you get excited? Because excitement is a mental process. By contemplation, you're excited. You didn't get something, you didn't get something, you didn't get something, something you get. That is called success pleasure. Anything you get freely, 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 the pleasure is only objective pleasure. That is why somebody says, I want to get married, and you'll think, oh, what, Akash, I'll go to heaven. After 5-6 months, like cats and dogs, they fight. Simple proof. Why? Because mental concoction has come down. But his brain is still asking. Because he's become familiar with his wife, their mental concoction is not coming. But his brain is still asking. So you look for? Hope in other women. How it is? The whole world is like this. So sex desire doesn't go by getting married. Doesn't go. Here it has to change. Wiring has to change. You have to change the wiring here. problem is not the objective pleasure. If the objective pleasure is there, then you know somehow you would have continued. That's why you see nowadays all immediately no pleasure, divorce. Doesn't continue. By chance, if some child is born, now that child is the one bonds the parents. Not sex life. It's an extension of sex life. The child, oh my child, my child. So, husband will tolerate, wife will tolerate and carry on life. It will go so many years like that because child has to grow up. Right? So, this is a trap of Maya. So this itself shows that 99% what you think sex is false. 1% is there. Now a rasgulla, if you see, or a gulab jamun, if you see, the objective pleasure is many times more than, almost you can say 90% is objective pleasure. 10% you may amplify. You know, delayed response. 10% you may amplify. In sex pleasure, 1% is objective pleasure, 99% is amplified. That is why it is said that, see, if somebody is selling you something, saying there is 100 units of pleasure and giving you 50 units, it's a less of a cheating. Suppose somebody is giving you 1 unit of pleasure and taking the price of 100, which is bigger cheating. So it is in sex that Maya does the biggest cheating. And you see, it is very interesting. The Shastras say this is a most difficult pleasure to get over. Why? Because 99% is in the mind. That is very difficult to get over. In reality, the pleasure is insignificant. But when it's concocted, there is more real pleasure in a gulab jamun than in sex. It's all amplified by the mind. And that business has started, amplification business. Maya, when did she begin? Right from when you are born as a baby. Because you realize, I'm a man, I'm a boy, I'm a girl. Chit, innocent curiosity, it has began as innocent curiosity. How a girl is different from a boy, how my mother is different from my father. It started like that. But it's all only in the head, because you cannot explore, you cannot find out. Society has all blocked. Suppose you are in the nude camp, amplification would have been very less. But then you will not have civilized life. That is the whole problem. Somebody may say self-realization, this is very good, no? Let's turn Hare Krishna into a nude camp. You also want to control sex, amplification, mental concoction. No. That uncivilized life. We have to learn higher rasa. Human form of life is meant for higher rasa and higher rasa and higher rasa and higher rasa. Animals have only that in the sex pleasure, gross sex pleasure, capture pleasure, chase pleasure, search pleasure, search and find, chase and capture. After capturing, indulge and enjoy. The three phases of sex pleasure. Earlier class, one of the class I had told you about. How I observed a cat sitting under that banyan tree. It was sitting like this. So I was in the veranda. I was watching this cat. The cat was sitting like this. And watching this side, that side, this side, this side. About 5 minutes I was watching. So I was thinking, what the cat must be thinking? Something it's thinking, no? Suddenly it became tight like this. One bird came and sat on a low branch. So the cat became very tight. Whole body tightened. Zoom! Jumped. And it successfully caught the bird. After catching the bird, it took it to one corner, safe place, what it thought was a safe place. Sat there nicely. Ate every feather. So, see how it happens. What was the bird doing first? What is the cat doing first? Searching. There's an object of pleasure. That is condition, an object of pleasure. Started searching. This searching is what? Like this. When the cats are sitting simply, they are not sitting simply. Please understand. They are searching. That's why you'll see. Searching, 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 searching. Suddenly find. Boom! Pleasure. Found one. So first level pleasure began. Jump! Catch! Capture. Next level ananda. Success. We are wired to take pleasure in success. Then you take, indulge your senses. So when you indulge in your senses, that is sense gratification. Now when you are indulging in your senses, one important thing, two successes have already put your excitement high. So when you actually indulge, when the cat is indulging and taking enjoyment in the indulgence, it is experiencing not only the happiness, the pleasure of indulgence, but also those two excitements are also added. So it is, gets amplified. So then when it is indulging, it is in an excited manner, it is indulging, that entire thing is captured in the memory of the cat. Next time, again sense object comes, the entire experiential memory comes up. That is, it is captured in the chittam, in the consciousness, in the contaminated consciousness, subtle body of the cat. So it learns like this. Next time, you just have to trigger that. This memory is tagged under the sense object. Tagged under the moment, sense object is again seen. So in the same way, it's like that. Our conditioning in our head with respect to sex desire also, there are three cycles. That is why people look at women. They, you want real brahmachari, of course in the world you have to live. You look, don't take the second look. Good formula. 1 second, because in the world you have to live. The man or woman you will recognize. Second look you should not take. Second look means your cycle is starting, search, find. You start measuring. You start assessing the opposite sex. The conditioning. And then, you know, you have your own pleasure belief. What is good figure? What is bad figure? Good figure means, oh, found something. Little pleasure, success pleasure goes inside. So, like this, you are just feeding chemicals in the head. Your big concoction. So that is how it is. 90%, 99% concoction. If you get over that 99% concoction, then very easy to take over, conquer sex. Therefore, it is said, the mind should be happy. If your mind is not filled with Krishna conscious happiness, then all this kind of desires will dominate and it will amplify.
Hare Krishna, I have two questions on this, Prabhu. One is this wiring is there from only from this life or previous janmas also?
One is?
The attraction between when we see the woman, that mind is amplifying. So this happening only from this janma or from previous janmas also?
This janma or previous janma? That is our chitta, doesn't matter. Our consciousness is a collection of all memories. That is why sometimes in the dream you see some things which you have never faced in your life, real life. It is there. This is an impression that is there. It's all there in the subconscious.
another one, the dopamine, the scientist said the dopamine chemical, it is something related with the sex desire, Prabhu.
Unless?
Dopamine will be released in the brain. Is the same thing related with the sex desire or just a chemical? What is that chemical, Prabhu, exactly? The dopamine.
That's what I said, chemical, dopamine, serotonin, there are so many, already the different kinds of testosterone, all the one, there's one chemical for search and find, there is another chemical for capture and chase and capture, there's another chemical for indulge and enjoy. All scientists have found out. There's one name for all these chemicals. Bhagavatam ki jai, Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada ki jai.
Hare Krishna. Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss any updates.